And what about the other contestants?
They are my grandfathers. They are old.
Okay, so I'm in circle and I'm here to ask Nigerians about their election tomorrow and see who they are rooting for. So if you want to know what or who they are rooting for or what they want the government to do for them, please stay tuned and do what, subscribe, like and share. Let's go. Tomorrow is the election day.
Yeah.
Who are you rooting for?
Who am I voting for?
Rooting for.
I'm rooting for Peter Obi.
Peter Obi?
Yeah.
Why?
Because I know he's capable of making Nigeria to be better.
He's capable of making Nigeria. And what about the other contestants?
They are my grandfathers. They are old. So I want Peter Obi to be there. So Nigeria will be better than before.
So we all know that Peter Obi doesn't have, let's say, in Ghana here, for instance, he doesn't have like MPs. When we talk about MPs, you understand, they take decisions in parliament.
Yeah.
He doesn't have much.
Yeah.
So how, like for me, if I think about that thing, it makes me a bit scared because taking decision, if he wins, will be very difficult. What do you think about that one thing?
Winning, I know what every youth, both online, both physical, even outside the country, everybody supported him. Because you know, we all know that he's capable of doing it, and we know that when he entered there, he's going to have power to change Nigeria. He's going to have power to do things, as he said. So I'm rooting for him, as you asked me for earlier.
But my last question is, why didn't you go and vote?
I didn't go because I don't want to go. It's not that I don't have my PVC, I have my PVC.
So you should have gone. And
I didn't
because
go.
One vote could have done something.
I know that, but I didn't go. But I know with my people over there, they're going to make it happen. It's going to win. It's going to win.
All right, thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Please, like, do you want to talk?
No, me
say something about it at least.
I say all of
between the, between Obi, atiku, tinubu.
Make I talk something. You say
at least those three. Who are you going for? Are you also going
me
for?
Me, I be Ghanaian. Me, I'm a Ghanaian, but me, I want Tinubu to win.
You want Tinubu to win?
Yes.
Why?
Because. See what you are talking here now. Say Peter Obi no have MPs, any MPs in Ghana. So if he come, you don't know what he go do.
That would be very difficult.
Yes. And people will see plenty Igbos where they Ghana here supporting Peter Obi. But you people didn't go and vote. So how can he win for you?
That's another problem.
So me, I support Tinubu to win. So say Nigeria go continue. The mafia level.
We Nigeria don't want to play terrorists in Nigeria again. Since 1960, criminals and terrorists are then they rule Nigeria. Now we want to take our country back. That's why we are supporting Peter Obi. So that's my further point.
Who are you rooting for?
For now.
Atiku, Tinubu and Obi.
Okay. Let me say, if Christ can trust Peter and make him the head of our apostles, why can't we trust Peter? That's not my point.
So the question that I asked about, he doesn't have MPs, like people who take decisions in parliament for him. If he doesn't have enough numbers in parliament, for instance, or in cabinet, okay, how can he like take his decisions?
You go with the one he has.
But you know that it will be difficult because normally what they usually do is majority. So they will, like they will say they should vote, and when they vote and the majority wins,
then this thing goes for the majority. It's in the law. Majority can raise the vote. That's it.
right now, I don't have any problem. But my last question that I want to ask, as I asked him, why didn't you people go? You are supporting Obi. Why didn't you go to vote?
I'll speak from my own perspective. Some of us are still finding their bearing financially. But there are people who are already established. They are down. They're already in Nigeria.
And like they've gone back.
They have gone back. Okay. So we are still young. We still came new here. So finding our bearing financially. So that's why. Our prayers are with them. Our prayers are with them. I believe God will
come tomorrow. We don't want terrorists again in Nigeria. We want to take our country back.
I think
since 1960, criminals and terrorists are not in Nigeria. So this kind of nonsense, this thing must stop. That's why we are supporting to stop.
Honestly, honestly, being a Ghanaian, I know that if Nigeria becomes even a little bit like the other countries that we have in Africa, Africa itself will be like, I don't know. I know definitely like Nigeria can easily compete with this America country.
Sure, you're right.
Easily.
If we become better, you go Africa, easily. We become better. If we become better,
Africa,
go
Africa, we become better.
So, this election, tomorrow, the world is watching.
Yeah.
And I believe God already has established something good will happen tomorrow. Our prayers have been answered by God. I believe so.
I'm really hoping so, honestly, because Charlie, we all want that. Just want that good governance and so that the country will come back again.
For 8 years now, that I've been if you go inside the net, if you're not careful, you develop high blood pressure. Seriously. We need peace. I believe tomorrow election will be a peaceful one.
It will surely be a peaceful one. We are praying.
You know, I don't get any other candidates.
Apart from, if you are going to vote.
Jagaban, number one. Who? No size, Jagaban.
Who is that?
Tinubu. Senator Bola Ahmed Tinubu, former governor of Lagos State, is my candidate. And he is the next president of Nigeria, no doubting. Maybe by vote, not be by, say, by power, by vote, then go vote in and he go win. Automatic.
But you know the thing is, on the internet, it's not like that. I'm really not seeing him.
Social media people will not vote, my man. Those people you see social media, you see on the internet, they are in diaspora. They don't have money to go home. Most of them don't get money. Their passport don't expire for diaspora. They no fit go home. They no get stay for diaspora. They no get anything. They no fit go back home. But if then they upload things pass. How many Nigerian citizens get credit, get data? Where go they upload
one person,
news?
One person that I know that he's not in Nigeria, but he's very active on social media. Two dead notes. Yeah, he's been posting.
Is he in Nigeria?
He's not in Nigeria.
Is that two dead notes where they stop? Is he going to vote?
No, that's the problem.
Who is Tunde Ednot? If I may ask you that, you are throwing me this question now. Who is Tunde Ednot?
He's a Nigerian that I know.
He's a blogger. Who are the bloggers? People that share fake news. Why are you mentioning? If you want to mention name, you don't mention a better name. Tunde Ednot. Who is Tunde Ednot? If he's hearing me, he should be hearing this. He's a blogger. And who is a blogger? Blogger are the people that put fake news on social media. For people to be carrying up and down so that they will gain their own money.
So my question is, why? Because all I see is Obi. On the internet.
I'm still repeating it for you, to you, and to everybody that is watching this thing.
Yeah.
The people that you are seeing on social media, they are saying Obi.
Yeah.
They are not going home to vote. They are in diaspora, just like the way I am.
Yeah.
They don't even have money for transport. Talk less of they have money to spend at home. But they have credits here. They have free data, free Wi-Fi. They can connect anybody. And they put anything online. They are in US. They are in African country, Chao, different African country. They are in Europe, Chao, in Turkey, in everywhere. Today, not is that where? Maybe UK.
UK or US.
And you see, say, BJ, they upload anything where you like. So, Obi, OB, uh-huh. is not going anywhere. We want youth. They say they want youth. Yeah. I'm a youth. Mm-hmm. Why they don't want me? Ben, and they see my face now. Ben, they should come and take me here. Ben, next 4 years, they say they should vote me in if they want youth.
But like you've not contested, so how can they vote for you?
So B2, they can't vote for him.
But like my last question is, why didn't you go? Like why didn't you go? Go and vote.
It's not that I didn't wish to go. Mm-hmm. Number one, yeah. I will not lie to you. I will say the truth to people, to masses, so that they will hear this. Okay. Number one, I don't have PVC. Okay. When they are doing the PVC, yeah. they call us to come back home. Okay. I couldn't go. Okay. It's not because of money. My document is legit, but based on the delay and one or two things make me not to show face. So I don't have my PVC. That's the main reason why I'm not going home. Secondly, the scarcity of money up and there, that the policy of swapping naira that they are bringing now,
yeah.
makes everything stand still for so many people that they have interest to go south. So those one too is affected. That is the second one. So those are the two reasons why I'm not home. But the most important one is I don't have PVC, so I'm not voting. And if you are not voting, you believe that you can go and destroy the polling unit. You are joking.
Hey, I've actually seen security, heavy security.
Then Kamma Dyn, if you believe that your candidate did not win, you want to do rubbish, you go here.
Heavy security.
Your family go feel them. So respect yourself. If you are in that Nigeria, if you are at home, you don't have your PVC, stay at home and hear the results. Don't go outside and be saying Tinubu will win. Obi is my candidate. If he doesn't win, we will fight like some celebrity, Nigerian celebrity. They are saying, we are hearing it.
Yeah.
Maybe it be their bloggers, like today I know that it's uploading it, so we can't see. They are saying that if Obi did not win, Nigeria will turn upside down. If you yourself that you are interviewing me want to say the truth, you have come across of it in social media. You can't lie, you can't deny that. So if you have that kind of mindset and you are in that country, I will advise you. We too, we are online 24. We are watching Nigerian news as we are here in diaspora. We are watching Nigerian news every blessed minute. Don't go and disturb the polling unit. Don't be oblongs.
That's
respect yourself.
That's a good advice.
Be a good citizen of Nigeria.
Yeah.
Pray for the better person to come.
Okay.
Don't be biased. Don't be because of I'm a so-so tribe. I want to go and disturb the polling unit because my tribe is not winning. Stop that.
That's
and vote responsibly.
Yeah, responsibly.
That's what.
Who are you rooting for?
I'm not voting because I don't have.
You're not voting?
Yes.
So I'm not voting anymore. So you don't have.
Yes.
But amongst all of them, who are you rooting for?
Anyway, I don't have candidate because all I want is better Nigeria. So whoever wins, that's
whoever wins. Yes. You are okay.
Yes.
Whoever wins.
Yes. My prayer is that I want somebody that will change Nigeria, that everything will be fine. So that's my prayer.
You want someone?
By all means, I know someone will win it.
Definitely someone will win.
Yes, so that's the prayer. Whoever will win it, it will change Nigeria to a better place.
So that's what you want. That's the only thing you need.
That is it.
You are not going for anybody.
No.
So what do you think about people who are saying we want Peter Obi?
That is their decision. That's their decision. Yes, that's what they think of. So you understand. Everybody have their own candidates.
Yeah.
But for me, I don't have. What I want is good Nigeria. By all means, someone will win. Then that's my prayer. Whoever wins should change Nigeria to a better place. So that's what I'm hoping for.
What is the reason? Why didn't you go?
Yeah, because I don't have PVC.
Okay, you don't have PVC. That's
yes, that time they are doing it, I'm here. So I was unable to go there to go. Yes. So if to say I have it, by all means, I have votes.
Go win. Tini, I've been a Tinubu, be name, na thief.
Tinubu be thief.
Tinubu.
Has he stolen something from you?
We all know Tinubu na thief. Then what will be the other one, Atiku? If Atiku rulers, I mean I see Boko Haram the rulers too. So me, I'm not gonna agree with Tinubu or Atiku rulers. So he said Peter Obi is the best. For me, Peter Obi
is the best.
Yes. So that
you
give him.
You know that he doesn't have enough people to support him to rule the nation or take decisions of the nation. Like, yeah. For instance, in Ghana here, we have MPs. So in Nigeria, you have people in cabinets that are his people that can take decisions for him in parliament, but he doesn't have enough people.
God takes.
You say?
Leave it for God.
You leave it for God?
Yes, sir.
So you want him to win? That's all you want?
For sure. He's a winner.
Okay.
Because Tini Abi Tinubu Soro.
Yeah.
Abasha Abi, what is it called? Atiku.
Yeah.
Hey, Boko Haram go see the leaders. We not come for suffer. No. We need Peter Obi.
Peter Obi.
Yeah. We need Peter Obi.
Okay.
Sure.
So, like, my question is, why didn't you go to vote? As you are supporting Peter Obi.
I didn't go because I don't have the PVC card.
I don't have PVC.
I don't have the.
I think they gave some time for people to go.
I was not around for the. I was in.
Okay, you were in Ghana, so you couldn't go.
So I couldn't go.
Okay.
Hey.
That's between Peter Obi and Atiku and Tinubu.
Voila. I would like Peter Obi to be there. I know he will collect your own money.
He will do what?
Like your own money. He will still collect your own.
His salary.
No, we should be salary.
Or bribe.
Or you are talking about follow for there. No, be salary. Like in your own money.
Okay.
You will see collect amo.
You
will remember the promises.
Okay.
Other ones.
Article.
Atiku. No good aside. Tinubu self a fear and pass snake.
Really?
Sure.
So why do you have so much trust in
Obi?
Yeah.
Okay. Nah. Voila. Obi, even with starting with the name, you can not say Natros. Even say the name Natros.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. The first name Natros.
Mm-hmm.
So for him to enter,
Obi is trust in Nigeria.
Okay.
And in Ghana, Obi is like somebody. That's the meaning in Ghana. Somebody, Obi.
Somebody.
Yeah.
In my language, Obi.
You didn't know it.
Obi. In my own language, you've been a first son.
First son,
yes.
Okay.
So, first son, they always do good.
Yeah, Abi? Yeah, sure.
That's fine. Come be saying a bit of ego enter. No person will be know again. Yes. Any other person, I can't.
Mm-hmm.
A bit of be everything. You, quite if the votes they give you, where they are, so you.
Yeah,
you.
Yeah.
If a mistakenly carry a vote, go give what do they call it? Atiku, Abi Tinubu. You don't lose, so. Make you know. So now Peter Obi go there, no much talk again.
So my question is why didn't you go? Why didn't you go and vote for like Peter Obi?
No, well, I don't get money.
You don't get money, transport.
Yes, now they're supposed to come carry me for you, go there, my vote. If now I was Sam go carry three last go pilot, even so now maybe they go, maybe their people come.
No, yes, like what you are saying is true though, but like mostly in Ghana, what usually these politicians do is they transport people within Ghana from wherever across, like to go and vote. But I don't know about different country. I don't know about that one.
And also, it's supposed to be like I'll be as person where it's supposed to just free car for people. Like there are many people, there are many Nigerians, mostly Igbo, that here in Ghana they don't have money to go back to Nigeria. So like this would be the opportunity, like for them to go, like. Go back and even to vote, because you may say Peter Obi to win, you don't have the PVC.
Exactly.
If you want your brother to win, you go back to Nigeria and vote for him. But this one, me say, we got no get money to choose, I can't be to transfer to Nigeria. So me, normally by my choice, I want Peter Obi to be here, because you remember the promises. Others, their life gone asleep. I'm about to do, I go tell you, I'm playing. Because we see normally Peter Atiku, don't you call him? Tinubu. Normally, that man, that one seven. He won a revolution. Nobody go fit talk. Understand? So that is the everything.
Who are you rooting for?
Oh, my support is from Peter Obi.
Your support is from Peter Obi.
Yeah.
Why?
Peter Obi is a good man.
He's a good man.
Yeah, he has ruled Anambra State.
Okay.
For the 8 years, he did not borrow from anybody.
Okay.
When he was living, he still left millions of dollars and naira for the state account.
Okay.
So when you have that kind of a leader,
yeah,
you will be happy. And also, he has told others his government will be from consumption to production, which we can produce and export. So I support him 100%.
Support him 100%.
Yeah.
But my question is, you know, his party is not like big than like the other parties. That's APC and PDP.
Yeah. Yeah.
But and he doesn't also have much MPs. Like when we talk about people who are going to take decisions on his behalf on cabinet or in cabinets, for instance. So like there are not many like that. And you know, in governance, it's very difficult if you don't have enough people in cabinet. So like, how do you think he's going to take decisions so that he can rule Nigeria and everything that he has promised, he can do it?
You see, Nigeria is looking for change.
Okay.
And we, the youth, we will support him by all means. He has done it in Anambra State when he won the election in APGA.
Yeah.
Most of the legislative, they are in PDP.
Okay.
So still yet, he still do something in Anambra State.
Okay.
That means those people, they don't have say. Once he bring the presentation to the table, the Nigeria people will follow it up.
Okay.
Yeah.
And my last question is, why didn't you go to vote?
Okay. Yeah.
Why? Why?
You see.
Because we are rooting for him and
yes.
Your votes.
Like me, I have called all my family members,
okay.
My mother, my father, my brother, my sister, because since I'm working, sending money to them.
Yeah.
So I have a say over them also. I have to tell them that if you want things to be better,
This
is the person you vote for.
And
I have to convince them. They were all saying that, oh, all politicians, they are the same. But I told them that everyone is not the same. We have looked into this one, this man's record. He has done it somewhere. So let us try him again. So I called my father, I called all my people that they should vote for Peter Obi. Even though in my hometown, some of my friends, my colleagues, we were dragging, and I give them reason to vote for Peter Obi. So at least I'm not there, but I have put my own effort to support him.
I think that's good.
Yeah,
like their vote will be difficult.
Yeah. Even though this evening, I will still call my father, call my boy, to remind them again. Tomorrow is Peter Obi.
That's very good. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Me, I support Peter Obi.
Obi?
Yes.
Why?
Oh, he's a good man.
He's a good man.
Yeah.
And you think he can do the job?
Oh, why not?
More than Atiku.
Yeah, he's a young man, he's a youth man. I cannot go and support the old man, 70 years, 80 years.
So
Peter Obi is a
someone who is younger?
Yeah, he's a nice man.
Okay.
So I support him.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah. I support Peter Obi.
Same.
Yeah, all Peter Obi. Yes. Because first, Peter Obi is a Christian.
Okay.
He's a man of
principle.
Yeah. So moment he says something, we do it.
Okay.
So he's from my state. He's my former governor. So I support him.
Thank you.
Peter Obi is fighting for Nigeria. He's not fighting for Igbo. He's fighting for Nigeria. Yes. No, he's fighting for Nigeria.
Okay.
I support Peter Obi.
You support Peter Obi, why?
Yeah, because he's a good leader. And I'm sure everyone wants him to win. You see?
You are sure everybody wants him to win?
Yeah.
What have you seen? Like, what have you seen about him? That
I've heard about him that he's good. Okay. And he'll be a good leader if he wins the
election.
Yeah. I'm sure, and I've seen it. So I support him, and I'm sure I'm not the only one.
Yeah, definitely.
So he's a good leader.
And
I'm supporting and I'm voting for him. So.
And my question is, why didn't you go Nigerian
vote? I wish I could, but.
So what's the problem? Is it financial?
Nah, yeah, it's kind of that, but you know, I have things to do, but
okay.
I wish I could. Yes.
Who are you voting for tomorrow's election?
Yeah. Like Nigeria is my country.
Yes.
I prefer Peter Obi.
You prefer Peter Obi? Why not Tinubu or Atiku?
Yeah, because I say Peter Obi is very young and he has intelligence to make things work.
Okay.
Yeah.
So that's the reason why you are rooting for him.
Yes. Tinubu is. I'm a Yoruba. Tinubu is a Yoruba, but we are not tribalism. stuff now.
Like nowadays, like it's like you are like I've actually seen that like you people are not going because
because it's a Yoruba Igbo. No. We want the best thing for our country.
One country. Okay.
Yes. I know he's not God. He's the only God that is perfect. But at least with the way he talk, with the history he has, I mean, Peter Obi, he can make things work in Nigeria. Yeah. And I pray to God, God will make it. Yeah.
Like we are all hoping for the best. So.
Amen.
My last question is, why didn't you go?
I can't travel for now. I can't travel to my country. Like the way things are going, so I need to stay here for a while. I don't want to go for now.